For this video lesson, pag-aaralan naman natin ang operations on decimals. Decimals are also rational numbers, but these decimals must be terminating, that means bilang lang yung digit sa decimal, or pwede rin naman yung mga repeating decimals. So let's have addition and subtraction of decimals. They just have the same rule. First is to align the decimal points of the given, then perform the operation as you would in whole numbers. And don't forget to affix the decimal point aligned with the given. So let's solve the following. So number 1, 0.73 plus 0.28. First is we should align the decimal points of the given. So, sanay tayo na vertical mag-add. So, we need to align it properly. And then, perform the operation as you would in whole numbers. So, dahil naka-align na yan, perform lang natin yung operation. 3 plus 8, 11. 7 plus 1, 8 plus 2, 10. Carry 1. And then, 1 plus 0, that's 1. And then, don't forget to affix the decimal point aligned with the given. Kumbaga, parang bring down lang yung decimal point. That will be 1.01. Number 2, again, align the decimal point and then add the usual way. Dahil walang katapat yung 3 dito, pwede kang mag-add dito ng 0 or just leave it blank. 3 plus 0 is still 3. 7 plus 8, 15. 2 plus 1, 3. 5 plus 1, 6. Again, don't forget to affix the decimal point aligned with the given. So this one is 6.353. Number 3, we have negative 0.7 plus 3.25. Notice that we are adding two different signed numbers. So when we add different signs, we actually get their absolute values and subtract them. So here, the absolute value of this is 0.7, this one is 3.25, and then subtract. So since mas mataas yung absolute value ng 3.25, ilagay natin to sa taas, minus 0.7. So now let's perform the operation. 5 minus 0, 5. 2 minus 7 cannot be, so we need to borrow from here and make it 12. 12 minus 7, that's 5. And then 2 minus 0, 2. Affix the decimal point. So we have here 2.55. Since they are different signs, subtract and copy the sign of the higher absolute value. The higher absolute value is 3.25, which is positive. That's why our answer will remain positive. Number 4, we are given a subtraction operation wherein we have two given that have different signs. Remember that in subtraction, we follow the rule keep change and change. And when we add two negative numbers, we simply add them the usual way, 5.203 plus 2.25. Since decimal to, kailangan i-align natin ang mga decimal points and then perform the operation. 3 plus 0, 3, 0 plus 5, 5, 2 plus 2, 4, and 5 plus 2, 7. And since we added two negative numbers, we copy their common sign. So we'll have here negative 7.453. Okay? So ganun pa rin, in adding and subtracting decimals, we align the decimal points of the given and perform the operation. Pero kapag nagkaroon tayo ng different signed numbers, we need to remember the rule in adding and subtracting them. So now let's proceed to multiplication of decimals. Here, we multiply the numbers as you would in whole numbers, then count the total number of decimal places and show it in the product. Ibig sabihin, i-multiply lang natin to the usual way. So let's multiply 3 times 2, 6, 3 times 0, 0, 8 times 3, 24. Now, we need to consider the decimal places in the given. Here, we have 2, while the second one, we have 1. We must have 3 decimal places in the product. So from here, we count 1, 2, 3, put the decimal here. Therefore, number 1 has the answer 2.406. Next, number 2, negative 5.12 times negative 0.43. Since we have two negative numbers, the answer will become positive. So let's just multiply it the usual way. 5.12 times 0.43. 3 times 2, 6. 3 times 1, 3. 5 times 3, 15. And then 4 times 2, 8. 4 times 1, 4. And 4 times 5, 20. And then add the partial product. So here we'll have 6, 8 plus 3, 11, 5 plus 1, 6 plus 4, 10, carry 1, 1 plus 1, 2, and bring down 2. And let us consider the decimal places of the given. Here we have 2, and here we also have 2. That's 4 decimal places. So the answer here is 2.2016. Next, number 3, 0.023 times 0.7. So we multiply it the usual way, 7 times 3, 21, 7 times 2, 14, plus 2, 16, carry 1, 7 times 0, 0, plus 1, 1. 7 times 0 is still 0. No need to put 0 here or pwede rin naman. Now let us consider the decimal places. We'll have 4 decimal places, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we put the decimal here. So, kung sakaling hindi nyo ito nalagyan ng 0 kanina, dapat ay lagyan yan. Pati kapag wala tayong whole number dito, you must put 0 here. Therefore, we'll have 0.0161. But considering that the given are different signed numbers, positive times negative will be negative. So here in multiplication, we simply multiply them and consider the decimal places of the factors to be put also in the final answer. We're down to the last operation, which is about division of decimals. First, if the divisor is not a whole number, move the decimal point to the right to make it a whole number and move the decimal point in the dividend using the same number of places. Then we divide the usual way and put the decimal point directly above the decimal point in the dividend. So let's use those steps in these examples. Number 1, using the long division method, we put the dividend inside the division bar, so we'll put here 9.5 divided by 6.4, which is the divisor. So since the divisor is not a whole number, we need to move the decimal point to the right to make it a whole number, to make it 64. So here, we just simply move it once, so we also move the decimal point here once. And then, pwede na rin natin itong ilagay directly above for the quotient. So, 95 divided by 64 is 1, and then 1 times 64 is 64, subtract 5 minus 4, 1, 9 minus 6, 3, and then we can add 0 here to continue the division process. So 310 divided by 64 is 4. 4 times 64, that is 256. So we subtract here, we'll have 10 minus 6, 4, 0 minus 5 cannot be. So we borrow from here, and then this will be 10 minus 5, 5, and 2 minus 2, 0. So we'll have the remainder 54. Let's continue the process by adding 0, bring it down, and then divide. 540 divided by 64 is 8. 8 times 64 is 512. And then subtract from 540, that will be 28. So here, the division continues, but let's just stop it this way. So let's just have the final answer, 1.48. Next, number 2. Since we have two negative numbers, their answer will become positive. So let's just divide them the usual way. 78.6 divided by 0.12. So again, the divisor is not a whole number, so we need to move its decimal point two places to the right to make it a whole number 12. So 1, 2, and then we also move the decimal point in the dividend. So add 0 here at nandito ang ating decimal point. And don't forget to put decimal point in the quotient. So here we'll have 7,860 divided by 12. 78 divided by 12, 6. 6 times 12 is 72. Subtract 8 minus 2, 6. Bring down 6. Continue the process. Divide 66 divided by 12, 5. Times 12, 60. Subtract 6. Bring down 0. 60 divided by 12 is 5 also. 5 times 12, that's 60. And then we don't have a remainder. So nandito yung decimal point, therefore the answer is a whole number, which is 655. So let's summarize the operations on decimals by trying the following examples. Number one, that's addition of decimals. So we align the decimal point of the given and add the usual way. 5 plus 4, 9. 9 plus 6, 15. And then affix the decimal point aligned with the given. So we'll have here 15.9. Number 2, this is subtraction of decimal numbers. Also, we align the digits and perform the operation. 5 minus 0 is 5. 2 minus 2, 0. 0 minus 1 cannot be. So borrow from here. So it will become 10 minus 1. 9, and 6 minus 6, 0. Do not forget to affix the decimal point. So we'll have here 0.905. Number 3, in multiplying decimals, we multiply them the usual way. 9 times 3, 27. 9 times 5, 45, plus 2, 47. And do not forget to count the number of decimal places here. So we have one decimal place here. Ito wala. So we'll have just one decimal place in the final answer. So we'll have 47.7. And number 4, it's division. 8.5 divided by 0.05. To divide decimals, we need to make the divisor a whole number. Dahil 0.05 yan, we need to move the decimal point two places to the right. Ganun din ang ating dividend. So kapag kulang, lagyan natin ng 0, and then lagyan din natin ng decimal point ang quotient. So let's divide first 8 divided by 5, that's 1, times 5, 5, subtract. Bring down, repeat the process, divide, subtract, and meron pa tayong ibibring down, divide that, that's 0, 0 times 5, 0, and then subtract. At dahil wala na tayong ibibring down, this is the final answer. So the final answer here is 170. So I hope na review kayo on how to perform the operations on rational numbers, specifically decimals that are terminating or repeating. Thank you.